This is the story of Granite City, Illinois, a town of 38,000 people on the Mississippi River just to the east of St. Louis, Missouri. And this is the story of how Granite City's citizens gathered together to win an All-America award from National Municipal League and Look magazine, and how they in turn celebrated that award, bringing attention upon the nation that Granite City, its citizens, were proud of their community and were working hard to make their community a bright spot in this nation. Granite City is an industrial community with 112 basic industries, steel being its backbone, fabrication of steel, manufacture of food products. Here we see the City Hall, where the city fathers and the citizens of our community gather to see that we have our proper zoning, that our streets are properly patrolled, and that the traffic is properly taken care of. Because it was in these areas that Granite City won its All-America Award. It won its All-America Award for people working together toward community good. And now, as the first glimpse of our community, we see one of the favorite sights for the Sunday visitor to Granite City. The Granite City locks and harbor, the longest locks in the Western Hemisphere, 1,200 feet long. The Chain of Rocks Canal was built by the U.S. Corps of Engineers to circumnavigate the most dangerous shoals on the Mississippi, the famed Chain of Rocks Ledges. And here we see the locks in operation as a tugboat comes from upriver bearing its load of ore and fuel and fabricated products for the ports of the nation and the world. Continue its tour on south, we take a glimpse to the north and the modern harbor facilities of the Bi-State Harbor. In addition to the Bi-State Agency, there is the newly developed Tri-City Port Authority, which has at its dedicated aim a development of transportation. And now we see the smokestacks of Granite City Steel's open hearth furnaces, trailing their smoke to the sky and heralding good news, men working, profits being made, and payrolls being earned. And here we glimpse the area behind the mill. This is a scene of progress. not one of degradation. Boarded up buildings that we see behind the mill show that this is an area which is going to be developed industrially. It's going to be expanded, that it's meeting the zoning requirements and the development of our community needs. Here, the boarded up windows do not portend the old and the torn, but new developments such as our new Coolidge Junior High School. Here we see the junior high school which was developed with the $3.5 million bond issue that every citizen from every walk of our community banded together to make sure that we in Granite City had good educational facilities to provide the youth of our city and also to provide for our future leadership. And here we see another community pride, the Memorial Gymnasium. Here is where the citizens of our community, the children of our community, can build healthy bodies in sound minds. In another aspect of community development, our town has grown. No longer do we have the narrow lots and the undeveloped plots of yesteryear. Here we see the new residential developments of our community and the pride that the householders have in developing their area, not only as a place worthwhile in which to live, but also a joy for the visitors to come and see. And we take a jump to the west side of our town now, and in answer to the ever-expanding population and growth in the school enrollment, here we see a newly developed Logan School, the answer to the overdeveloped school condition. And just to the west of Logan School, we see the steel skeleton of the new Westside Junior High School being constructed from the funds of the second school bond issue, meeting the needs of the community. And again, 6 months later, to show the development and the progress of our construction and of our working together. And now, one of the other many proud things that our community may boast, the Granite City Firehouse, the first civic building of its type to be built by our community since 1929. Here we see the modernistic structure which will house our first engine companies, the sleeping quarters for the firemen, the training facilities for our firemen, and reducing the hazardous condition of the old downtown fire department. Our city fathers and our citizens may take pride in being able to say that we too have a new 100-bed addition to our St. Elizabeth's Hospital. Because here it was where 375 people from every walks of life and every creed, Protestant, Catholic, and Jew, worked together to raise the money. Yes, Granite City's emblem of achievement, an emblem of achievement in education, in civic progress, and in labor relations. Application in for an All-America City Award on those wonderful emblems of progress which they made. And lo and behold, in January of 1959, they received the news that Granite City, the town who refused to be called out, was appointed and nominated an accolade of National Award, the All-America City Award of the National Municipal League, and Look magazine. And the citizens gathered together to determine how this award should be celebrated, how it should be brought to the attention of both our community and the nation as a whole. And so the first thing that the All-America Citizens Committee thought that they should do was have a flag-raising ceremony. And on January 20th of 1959, they gathered the forces of the community together to have a flag-raising award. And here we see the troops of the Granite City Engineer Depot, the mighty John missile, and the mechanization of the depot forces. Ceremony was held at the front lawn of the City Hall, and here we see Rod Schoenlank and Ernie Vile, chairman of the All-America Citizens Committee, making a charge to the community and presenting the All-America City Award flag to Granite City's first citizen, the Honorable Leonard Davis, mayor of Granite City. In turn, he hands it to the troops of the depot, and it's placed upon the standard, proudly waving in the air, proclaiming Granite City, All America City. Following the ceremony, we see now the Granite City fathers, the aldermen, having their picture taken for publicity purposes. In the foreground, Colonel Waters, who's no longer with us. And then we take a skip and a jump, and the days roll by, and February is here, and we have the month of our All America Award banquet. Highlight of the banquet was the keynote address by the Secretary of Labor, Secretary James Mitchell. And here we see the arrival of Secretary Mitchell at Lambert Air Force, being met by a group of the All-America City representatives. Here we see Robert Gibson of AFL-CIO Community Services, Mr. Sam Meyer, President of the Chamber of Commerce, and other members of the Granite City delegation. See the symbol of labor management unity with Secretary Mitchell, representatives of the Manufacturers Association and the representative of organized labor, shaking hands with one another and shaking hands with Secretary Mitchell. It was because of Granite City's forward progress in the 10-point labor peace progress that Secretary Mitchell wished to visit Granite City and to take part in this national award. And now we see the glyphs of the festivities, the preparations for the All-America Award banquet. Here was the largest banquet ever held in the city of Granite City. Now, just prior to the head tables taking their places, we see Secretary Mitchell with representative of management and of labor. And now the head table is forming. We see being seated Secretary Mitchell. The lovely decoration, the bunting, and the All-America Award designation behind the speaker's platform was made by the art class of Granite City High School. Here we have Reverend Calvin Markham with the invocation. And now, to start the evening's festivities in a light which should be shared by national observance is American Legion Post 113 of Granite City with the posting of the colors. Around the hall, we can see representatives of every walk of Granite citizenry. Here we see the city fathers gathered with their wives. In another corner, we can see representatives of management, representatives of labor, people from organizations of every type. Yes, this was Granite City's finest hour, as the paper proclaimed. A gathering of 1,035 Granite citizens who joyously proclaimed with the city the All-American Award accolade. Representative of Southwestern Bell Telephone, Tri-City Printing in the background. And here the editor of our paper, Mr. and Mrs. Townsend. At the head table, we see the Reverend Michael Costello, the Chamber of Commerce, Rod Schoenlank, and his lovely wife, Polly. Next to Mrs. Schoenlank is the representative of Municipal League, James Singer. And here we see the lovely Mrs. Leonard Davis and the mayor of our community. Next to the mayor is Mrs. Vile and the chairman of the Citizens Committee, Ernie Vile, seated next to Secretary of Labor, James Mitchell. Here we see the representatives of Look Magazine from Chicago, Mr. and Mrs. John Mulkey. And the president of Tri-City Ministerial, Reverend Calvin Markham, and his wife, Twyla. Thank you. a dramatic note to the end of the evening is the dessert course, which is brought by a parade of waiters all flambé. The entertainment for the evening was provided by the House High School a cappella choir under the direction of Warren Simpkins. Here, the beautiful faces Representative Lloyd Curley Harris presenting to the city of Granite City a resolution from the State House of Representatives to Mayor Leonard Davis and to the Chamber of Commerce. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is the stuff that dreams are made of. One of the keynotes of the evening was the presentation of the All-America Awards to the All-America Boys and All-America Girls, chosen by their schoolmates from every school and every room in our community. Here we see President of Chamber of Commerce Sam Meyer and the mayor of our community presenting to these chosen leaders of the future the winged victory. Joining the All-America Boys and Girls are representatives of our youth agencies, the Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts, the Sea Scouts, and YMCA, bearing the standards of the All-America City, which the children in turn take back to their school. And now, presenting the compliments of Look Magazine is John Mulkey of Look's Chicago office. And John Singer of the National Municipal League makes the actual presentation of the All-America Award. The award, he said, was not presented for municipal perfection, but it was presented for the people of Granite City's ability to work together to commonly solve the problems of community development. In accepting the award, Mayor Davis spoke with humility and accepted it on behalf of every citizen of the community. And following the award presentation in the same keynote, Secretary of Labor James Mitchell brought attention upon the nation that they could well emulate the example set in Granite City, where labor and management was able to sit around the same table and together find the solutions to the problems besetting so many. Truly, the Secretary of Labor said that if the rest of the nation could follow Granite City's example, labor management problems would be at a minimum. And now, the Reverend Michael Costello with the benediction. The days raced long as they followed one another, and it came March. And here we have the wearing of the green and the planting of the green. We see Gary Owen and our alderwoman, Betnick. And now the high school band with the energetic twirlers. The well-scrubbed faces of our children remind us that juvenile delinquency in Granite City is low, and the community aims to keep it that way. Through the support of the United Fund, through the youth and guidance agencies of the YMCA and the Boy Scouts, the coordinated youth agencies, yes, in our teen towns. And here we have Mayor Davis wishing a mighty fine St. Patrick's Day wearing of the green to the beautification of the City Hall lawn. And now, the gathering of the various representatives of the city's garden clubs. And you can read the signs as the camera pans over the lovely ladies wearing their capes and hats of green. And here the mayor is putting in the first shovelful, patting down the shrubs which are destined to become the leadership in the community for new development and new community pride. We see some of our aldermen, Alderman Schmidhu, the mayor, Alderman LeMaster, and our alderman, alderwoman, Gabriel Becknig. Master of ceremonies, Gary Owen. President of the Associated Retailers, Mr. Joseph Glick. And again, the good luck green tie. Take a skip over to Logan School, where we watch the children as they receive the All-America Award as presented by the Logan School All-America Boy and All-America Girl. Here we see the principal, Miss Eva Meyer, presenting Logan School and Logan School Annex All-America Boy and Girl. In addition to competing for the All-America Boy and Girl Awards, the children of our school system also took part in essay contests, donating and dedicating Granite City as an All-America City. In addition to the essay contests, poster contests were held and slogan contests, coming up with the best solutions to why Granite City was named All-America and what must be done to maintain it as such. And here we see the Boy Scout troop and their bugle as they gather around the flagpole, ready to make the presentation awards ceremony and the flag raising for Logan School. The months rolled by, and again the Citizens Committee got busy. Here it was springtime. It was time for planting, and it was time for one of the many other observances that the Citizens Committee decided that they would hold during this six-month celebration period. And here we see a community beautification project taking place in the 24th Street Islands. This was only one of many city beautification projects that took part during the year. There was also a planting in the island at the Y at Namioki Road in the garden clubs of our community also gathered together and each accepted certain projects for the development and the beautification of our community. And now we see the crowning of All American Mother, Mrs. DeRuntz, receiving the robe of honor from Mayor Leonard Davis after having been chosen as Granite City's All American Mother. In the month of April, we also had our All-America Church Month, where the religious organizations of our community gathered together for observances to the strengthening and dedication of our citizens to their religions. Keynote of that day was Governor Frank Clemens. And then came June, and with it, June, came the All-America Father of Granite City, and here we see Mr. Glenn Abenroth receiving the congratulations and a plaque from Mayor Leonard Davis attesting to the award. Our nation became strong through the unification of ideas of many, many of its citizens. In the early days of our frontier, the early democratic communities gathered together and shouldered upon themselves community responsibilities. If a problem existed in one community, it became the job of every one of its citizens. This again is true in our community, and here we see the city fathers who are gathered together who also shoulder the responsibilities of the city's administration. American community, a community where democracy exists, where the grassroots level of citizen accept responsibility and work together toward the development of their problems. Thank you. Rylan's parade, we see the crowd gathering, less than 30,000 people lining the streets with the line in order to watch what was known as Granite City's largest and most impressive parade. Here we see the vital magnificent graces of our youth. Escorted by the Granite City Police Department, the beginning elements of the parade, approaching the reviewing set, the dignitaries getting out of the convertible, getting on the stand. Held in the center with the microphone in his hand is the parade marshal, Mr. Carl Lambert. Here we see the Abel Smith Company United Fund Club. At the daybreak, optimists will smoke, depicting recreational activities in the show. The Mexican Honorary Society ended this vote and, for its gullible presentation, won an award. Thank you. Get a quick glimpse of Union starch, floats, building blocks of progress. Contrasting past and future, we see Alderman Don Parkley and his wife, together with Mrs. Birchfield, the old Surrey with the fringe on top. Thank you. romantic reminiscences, and what could be more fitting following a good old-fashioned Independence Day parade than a good old-fashioned 4th of July picnic in the park. And many hundreds of Granite City families took advantage of the wonderful recreation facilities of Wilson Park in the quiet settings and the beautiful trees and surroundings to share in a safe and sane 4th celebration of American Independence Day. In the Park by John Tate's band. In the evening, immediately prior to the fireworks celebration, Ernie Vile, chairman of the Citizens Committee, gathered before the collective citizens of Granite City and paid tribute to the many hundreds of people who made this long 6-month celebration possible. Awards were presented to the All-American Boy and the All-American Girl, winner of the poster slogan contest, and the essay contest. Also awards were presented to the winners. Here we see Mayor Leonard Davis dedicating himself and the city government to a finer, a firmer community of the future, complimenting the citizens out there, working together and banding together to make a wonderful celebration of a wonderful national activity. So it came to pass that in 1959, the citizens of the city of Granite City were awarded the national acclaim All-America City by the National Municipal League and Look magazine. The award was presented on behalf of Citizen Action, working together to develop their community into a finer place in which to live, work, and earn a living. So it happened on July 4th, 1959, where we saw the culmination of a long 6-month celebration of this All-America accolade, where many thousands of Granite City citizens banded together, first in earning the award through labor management peace negotiations, through the development of hospital facilities, through the construction of new schools, through the establishment of better zoning provisions and better planning facilities. It would do well that we remember the democratic concept that our forefathers implanted upon this country of ours. It would do well for us to remember that in order to maintain a democratic community, every one of its citizens must shoulder responsibility to work together. Let us remember those words in 1776. Behold these two you shall live. That all men are created. That they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. That among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. And may we all remember that the consent of the governed is an active consent, one which generally takes part in the recognition of responsibility to community ideas.